Today, in our 12th standard physics class, we are now learning about the magnetism and magnetic effects of electric current, which is the third unit of 12th standard physics. This is our 13th session. In this session, we are going to learn about motion of a charged particle in a uniform magnetic field, motion of a charged particle under crossed electric and magnetic field, which is called as velocity selector. Let's move to the today's portion. Motion of a charged particle in a uniform magnetic field. Students, let us consider a charged particle of charge Q having a mass m which enters into a region of uniform magnetic field B vector with a velocity v, right? I will display and I will explain where the charge enters into the magnetic field. See, this is a uniform magnetic field and the charge Q enters into the magnetic field with the velocity v, and the magnetic field is B vector. The mass of the charge is m. As soon as the particle enters into the field, Lorentz force acts on it in a direction which is perpendicular, right? Which is perpendicular to both magnetic field B vector and the velocity v. This is perpendicular to the magnetic field and also the velocity v. As a result of this, the charged particle moves in a circular orbit, which is shown in the figure. The charged particle moves in a circular orbit. Now, the Lorentz force on the charged particle is given by F vector is equal to Q charge into V velocity into B vector, which is the magnetic field. Meanwhile, the Lorentz force along acts on the particle. The magnitude of the net force on the particle is summation IFI is equal to FM, which is equal to QVB. Already we know FM is known for magnetic force. This Lorentz force acts as centripetal force for the particle to execute circular motion. Therefore, let's have this as QVB, that means this right hand side into m into v square by r. Here the F is equal to ma. We know from the Newton's second law of motion, we take m and instead of v square by r, it is a. V square is the velocity divided by the distance or the time taken for one full rotation, one full this radius. Student, the radius of the circular path is, we have to define the value of r. R is equal to mv divided by q by b. We get this value of r from the earlier representation of q vb is equal to mv square by r. We take this r value only from the equation which we learned. Now, instead of mv, we know m is equal to momentum and linear momentum P, we put P instead of mv, where P is equal to mv is the magnitude of the linear momentum of the particle. Let T be the time taken by a particle to finish one complete circular motion. That means it takes the charge moves around in a circular orbit and it takes the time T for one complete circular motion. Here T is equal to 2 pi r divided by v. T is equal to 2 pi r divided by v. This you know, area of the circumference. Now substituting the value of 1 in 2, we get, that means we are going to substitute the value of r from the equation number 1, so we get T is equal to 2 pi m divided by qb, and the equation 3 is called the cyclotron period. The reciprocal of time period is the frequency f, and which is f is equal to 1 by t. F is equal to 1 by t, which is called as frequency. And by substituting the value of t from the equation number 3, we put f is equal to qb divided by 2 pi m. That is the reciprocal of t value. In terms of angular frequency omega, omega is equal to 2 pi f, which is equal to q by m into b. Now the equations 4 and 5 are called as cyclotron frequency or gyro frequency. Students, from equation 3, 4 and 5, we infer that time period and frequency depends only on charge to mass ratio. That means the specific charge, but not velocity or the radius of the circular path. Remember, if a charged particle move in a region of uniform magnetic field, its velocity is not perpendicular to the magnetic field. Then the velocity of the particle is split up into two components. One component is parallel to the field, while the other component is perpendicular to the field. So the component of velocity parallel to field remains unchanged, and the component perpendicular to field keeps changing due to the Lorentz force. Here the path of the particle is not a circle, it is a helix around the field lines, which is shown here. You can find this is not a circle, it is a helix. See, let's move to the next question. Motion of a charged particle under crossed electric and magnetic field, which is called as velocity selector. Dear students, let us consider an electric charge q of mass m, which enters into a region of a uniform magnetic field b vector with velocity v, such that the velocity is not perpendicular to the magnetic field, which we saw in the previous question. okay, which is, it's all related to the previous question. Only one thing is different from the previous question, that is the velocity is perpendicular in the previous and now the velocity is not perpendicular to the magnetic field. Remember, the path of the particle is a helix here. The Lorentz force on the charged particle moving in a uniform magnetic field can be balanced by the Coulomb force by proper arrangement of electric and magnetic fields. We know for a positive charge Q, the Coulomb force acts along the direction of an electric field, whereas the Lorentz force is perpendicular to the direction of the magnetic field. See, it is perpendicular to the direction of the magnetic field. To balance the Coulomb and Lorentz forces, both electric and magnetic fields must be perpendicular to each other, which you can see the electric field and the magnetic field are perpendicular to each other. Such an arrangement of perpendicular electric and magnetic field is known as cross fields. This is called the cross fields. To understand this, let us consider an experimental arrangement which is shown in this figure. In a region of space between parallel plates of a capacitor, you can see parallel plates of capacitor here, positive and negative charged, which the parallel plate produces uniform electric field because it has a positive and a negative plate. Now, uniform magnetic field is maintained perpendicular to the direction of the electric field. If this is the direction of the electric field, a uniform magnetic field is maintained which is perpendicular to the electric field. Suppose a charged particle enters this space from left side as shown. Okay, the charged particle is enters from the left side to this zone. The net force on the particle, we have to find the net force on the particle. The net force on the particle is F is equal to Q into E vector, that means the electric field, plus V velocity into the B vector. For a positive charge, remember, for a positive charge, the electric force on the charge acts in downward direction. The Lorentz force acts upwards. When these two forces balance one another, then QE is equal to QV naught B, or V naught is equal to E by B. You know, E represents the electric field and B represents the magnetic field. This means for a given magnitude of E field and B field, the forces acts only for the particle moving with a particular speed. Here the speed V naught is equal to E divided by B. The speed is independent of mass and the charge. If the charge enters into the crossed fields with velocity V, then let's see what it happens. So, if the charge enters into the crossed fields with velocity V other than V naught, it results in any of the following possibilities which is shown in the table, right? This is the table. In this table, you can see deflections based on the velocity and velocity selector. The serial number 1 represents V, the velocity V, which is greater than V naught. The deflection is charged particle deflects in the direction of Lorentz force. If the velocity V is less than V naught, then the charged particle deflects in the direction of Coulomb force. If V is equal to V naught, then no deflection and particle moves in straight. So, by proper choice of electric and magnetic fields, the particle with particular speed can be selected. Such an arrangement of field is called velocity selector. This principle is used in Bainbridge mass spectrograph to separate the isotopes. Thank you, students.